Hello and welcome to this special edition of Bharat Manthan, which is an initiative of Bharat Satsang. And continuing our discussions on the various sectors, the impact of budget on the various sectors like healthcare, defense, agriculture, and entrepreneurship, we take up the subject of agriculture with none other than Mr. Dr. Nalini Ranjan Kumar, who is presently working as principal scientist, agricultural economics at National Institute of Agricultural Economics and Policy Research in New Delhi. He's got 24 years of research experience in varied areas of agriculture and has got about 80 papers, 80 research papers published by him. So undoubtedly an authority on agricultural economics. So welcome, Dr. Kumar. And I would first of all like to know your first impression on the overall budget in a scale of 10. Where would you rate it?
In my opinion, this budget has, I can give 8 marks out of 10, sir.
8 out of 10. That's great. And so far as agriculture is concerned, and allied activities, what would you rate it at?
9.
Okay. Yeah. So 9 is a very, very high ranking, very high ranking. So let us try to understand why it is 9 and why it is not 8, why it actually outshines the even the general luster of the budget. What is there in for agriculture in it that makes it so outstanding?
The major problem of today agriculture is non-realization of right price to the farmers. And this budget, government has tried well to address this issue. One is through MSP, enhancing MSP, and another by creating marketing infrastructure. And third, value chain development of value chain and emphasizing on export, so creating infrastructure for export. So with this, the government is trying to address all the marketing problem. In the previous budget also, government has started this crop insurance scheme that is to cater the production risk of the farmers.
Okay. So now let's try to break it down and let's try to understand what was the MSP regime prior to this budget, or maybe the earlier budget, or maybe the earlier dispensation, and what is the scenario today? I mean, how is MSP, how it has been addressed, how it actually is going to impact the farmer? Will it impact the inflation rate also, because now the farmers would be getting a higher return, which eventually for the end consumer may result in a slightly higher prices? Are those assumptions and those apprehensions correct, or are we talking of only an imaginative situation, and that launching this MSP regime would actually address a very core issue of economy which has remained outstanding for a very long time?
So you might be aware that MSP was introduced during 60s to assure the farmers regarding the market prices of the crop when it arrives in the market. So since that, a number of development takes place, and right now the practice is to fix the MSP above this cost C2. Cost C2 comprises all the cash expenses of the farmers plus imputed value of farmlands, imputed value of farm rentals, imputed value of family labors, and even the fixed imputed interest rate of fixed capital.
Okay.
So that is practice. Now government has promised to provide this MSP at about 1.5 times of production cost. Still, it is not clear at what price government, at what cost concept government is going to fix. So at least price will be not less than this. It will be a little higher. And secondly, the government is going to have a system in which this will cover other crops too. At right now, MSP is being insured to farmers only in few crops. But now government trying to switch to a situation where government will pay farmers directly the difference between MSP and market price.
Okay.
So that will be a very good situation for the farmers, because most of the farmers in the country are not getting even MSP. So that will ensure a better price to the farmers.
Right. But what will be the impact to the end consumer?
End consumers, I don't think much will be affected, because for most of the consumer, 50% of consumers, government is providing food through subsidized ration. The higher income people do not bother about the prices of these food grains.
So the ones who really get affected will be taken care of by the food security of the government. Okay.
Yes.
So that's a good thing to happen. Now, one is the MSP. The other is the infrastructure that is being built. Now, where do you see the infrastructure as of today? Do you think it requires more allocation than what has been done in the budget, or do you think that this is sufficient to start with and then maybe build on it?
Certainly, this budget is not sufficient, but to start with, it is not a small amount. Okay. Government is trying to create infrastructure. At one go, government cannot create infrastructure throughout the country. But to start with, it has promised to renovate 22,000 markets, rural markets, into Gramin agriculture markets. That will be connected to e-NAM. And that will not be under the rule of APMC. So that will allow farmers to directly sell their food grains or any commodity directly to the consumer. So it will reduce this middleman, and certainly farmers' price realization will improve.
Price realization will improve. Plus, I think wastage will also be reduced.
Certainly, wastage will reduce because farmers will directly deal with the consumer.
Yes.
Another scheme government is trying to, through green, this Operation Green, like flood, government is trying to start some scheme in this fruits and vegetable, so that here value chain can be developed that will reduce the post-harvest losses and ensure the supply of this tomato, onion and potatoes at reasonable price to the consumers.
So the POT formula is being seriously pursued by the government.
Certainly, sir.
Okay. And do you think that this kind of intervention by the government in creating an infrastructure, in providing a reasonably good procurement price, will it change the agricultural patterns? Will there be more cash crops and less conventional crops, or the cash crops will receive some kind of impetus because of this? And the infrastructure that comes up, is it going to make people think of multiple crops in a place where they have not been doing it because of non-realization of the right profits.
Certainly, government is trying to create infrastructure for both the conventional commodity, rice, wheat, and this food grains, as well as fruits and vegetables. Fruits and vegetables command little higher prices, higher profits. Therefore, farmers will be motivated towards that.
Okay.
But that will take time.
So, given that you are into studying the economic part of agriculture, with this, whatever steps the government has taken, we have not talked yet about the export part. But given the first two things that we've discussed, what do you think would be the increment in the productivity of agriculture of the nation as a whole?
We are talking just about this marketing. Marketing will not create any incremental output directly, but indirectly, it will improve the profitability of farmers.
And profitability it will improve, but produce it may not.
Marketing, but government has this in budget. There is a provision of other things also,
like
this Prime Minister Krishi Sichai Yojana.
Yes,
it was started in previous budgets. It is continuing this year also, and government has put some handsome amount that will increase the area under irrigation. So that will increase the productivity and production of the crops. Again, the ongoing schemes of the government, like crop insurance and this soil health card, that will continue. Those will help in realization better output by the farmers.
Okay. So
Scheme, cluster-based development of agricultural commodities. Development of agricultural commodity will help in realizing large-scale production by the farmers, because our farmers are smallholders. More than 80% of the farms in India are either small or marginal. So they do not have large scale product. They do not have capacity to invest on larger farm machinery, and therefore their production is low. Production efficiency is low. With cluster based farming that government trying to encourage this FPO, farmers producer organization, that may help in enhancing use of more efficient equipment and farm machinery in agriculture, that will increase the production and productivity.
Okay. So could we say that with every succeeding budget, our agricultural activity, we are moving towards more scientific agriculture than whimsical agriculture that India has been generally having. Would that be a correct statement to make?
Certainly, sir. Certainly, we are moving towards scientific agriculture.
Okay. Now, given that all of us, are very aspirational, as Indians, we have suddenly become more aspirational after the advent of the Narendra Modi government. So, if you were asked what more you wanted in this budget, which has not been done by the government, what would be that one or two things that you would have wanted the government to do in this budget?
So, the most important thing is that strengthening of crop insurance scheme. Though it has been launched, but still farmers are not getting benefit. Most of the farmers are not aware about this scheme. We are visiting the rural areas and getting this feedback. So wherever we are going, we are getting this feedback about the crop insurance.
Okay.
That it is not, people are not coming to them. They are not aware. Just like for life insurance or health insurance, people used to go door to door, but for crop insurance, no such facilities there.
This is definitely one thing which depends much on awareness rather than just making a scheme available. I do agree. In fact, you would be surprised to know, I was surprised to know, a few days back I came to know that every LPG cylinder burst that happens, and if there is a death, there is an insurance of 40 lakhs which is available. But I do not see people knowing this fact. Similarly, the agriculturist also may not be really aware of the benefits available, two, the process to avail that benefit, three, the escalation in case of denial of service. I think all that does require a lot of work to be done on the field. So one thing that the government ought to have done in this budget is to strengthen the insurance scheme, crop insurance
extension system, which is in bad shape in most of the state.
Could you please elaborate a little?
Extension, agriculture extension system, through which this is farmers were taught about this scientific cultivation methods. And now these days, most of the state department has become program centric. So staff of this department do not take care about this extending the new technique to farmers. Rather, they are engaged in promoting or implementing their programs. So they are not helping in a much better way to the farmers, and farmers are still on the depending on the for medicine, they are depending still on these shopkeepers. Which medicine they should apply, they do not have clear cut idea, so they depend on the medicine supplier. So there should there is a need to strengthen the extension system.
What steps would you suggest? Do you think that there should be more agriculture advocacy groups which should be taking up this activity of extension?
Certainly, I'm not an expert in that extension activity, but my concern is that there should be a unified extension system. That because farmers grow agricultural crops, horticultural crops, rear fishes, animals, but when they need to know what should I do, there are different people in different locations, so they are not aware. So there should be unified extension system. At one point, at one location, farmers should get all information. And when some people are going, he should be able to explain each and everything, starting from crop production to livestock and fisheries too.
Wonderful. It's been a pleasure talking to you, Dr. Kumar. I think there are several subjects which need to be attended in the area of agriculture, and we would be at times relying on your expertise to discuss many of the subjects. And thank you very much for having joined us, taken out time for this wonderful discussion. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much. Thank you.